Hi, this is Matt at Custom Car Grills with a mesh install for a 2000 through 2002 Toyota Tundra. The grill shown in this video started off as an aftermarket one, but the install should be similar for OEM grills as well. To start the mod, I'm going to grab my open-ended saw blade. The first cuts I'll make will be on the bottom and top edges. I'll be staying about an eighth of an inch to a quarter inch away from the edge so I don't cut into it. Then it's time to make the big cuts on the main center bar. It's a little cumbersome to cut around and may require a couple of different angles of approach to cut it all the way through. The smaller horizontal bars I found to be a bit easier to manage as long as they were cut away from the center. With all the cuts made, the centerpiece should be easily removed and can be thrown away. To refine the cuts down, I'll grab my Dremel with the sanding drum attachment. I'm working down the remaining plastic from the cuts to be close to the edge while still trying my best not to dig into the edge itself. Once it's nearly flattened, I'll grab a couple coarse grit sandpapers. Refining the edges with the sandpaper should make them nice and flat. If there's any remnants of the stock bars on the top or bottom edges, they should be sanded smooth in this step. Also, at this point, I'm going to get my Dremel with a cutoff wheel attachment and trim off these spikes in the upper corners. Here's a quick shot of the grill thus far being cut and sanded really smooth. Everything looks real good, but it's pretty obvious that we have a few notches on the side that need to be filled in. To begin the repair process, I'm going to grab some thick craft tape and span it across the openings as a temporary barrier. Other tapes, such as aluminum tape, will also work really well for this step. Next, I'll grab my filler material, which is Valvoline's Plyo Grip Plastic Repair Number 3. On the back of the tape, I'm trying to get it into every crack I can, as well as build it up a little thick and a little high to ensure full coverage. Plyo Grip cures fast, so I'm working quickly during this step. Then, once it's cured, the tape can be removed and thrown away. With everything exposed again, I'll grab some more sandpaper and start smoothing this out one more time. Since the tape contours really well to the edge, there usually isn't a ton of sanding needed in this step. With that said though, the more thoroughly I sand here, the cleaner it will come out in the end. Here's how mine turned out after a few passes with some finer grit sandpapers. Overall, it's looking pretty good. The next step is a little tricky, and I'm going to use some red electrical tape to help. Because the stock hood latch is encroaching into our mesh area, we need to trim the lower edge to account for some of the mesh and the hood latch. So, what I'm doing is I'm using the tape to make a consistent line at a fixed depth to trim the lower edge. Using a Sharpie to draw the line can be a good backup plan to have if the tape is not sticking well. To start the cutting, I'll use my saw blade to make a cut by the latch down to the tape. Then, I'll grab my Dremel and equip the number 543 cutting and shaping wheel and start shaving the plastic back like so. Once I've shaved enough off, I'll test fit our mesh to make sure that there's enough clearance for the latch handle to fit, as well as for the latch rod to swing. After I'm satisfied with the lower edge depth, I'll use some more tape in preparation for shaving the side areas. This will blend the top and bottom edges to have a more consistent depth and a better overall appearance. After a few passes with the cutting and shaping wheel, there will be a noticeable improvement with the edge transitions. Here's a quick look at the final cuts that I made on this frame. Overall, everything's looking really good, but I'm going to need to fill in all the small imperfections before paint. To do that, I'm going to grab my favorite finishing putty, Blaze Glaze. I'll dispense a medium amount of putty, or at least enough to cover most of the areas. Then I'll add a pinch of hardener and start mixing it up. Once it reaches a consistent bluish color, then it's good to go. This hardens up quickly, so I need to work fast. I've got a small plastic squeegee that's great for applying the putty. After this cures, I'll sand it all smooth with some fine grit sandpapers, like a 320 or 400 grit. By now, I've got it ready for paint. All the edges are smooth and consistent. For paint, we went with a flat black finish, and it turned out amazing. I can tell that the grill is going to look awesome, and we don't even have the mesh in yet. Speaking of the mesh, here's a look at the mesh piece that we have for sale on our website. It's pre-cut and pre-bent to the shape and size needed to do this mod as shown in this video, with all the right cuts made for the hood latch and upper brackets. Depending on how the outer lower edges were cut and finished, some slight bends to the back of the lower corners may be needed. The hood latch area should be a tight fit. Slightly pulling the latch tab down may be needed to slide the mesh on. If the mounting bolts were removed at any point, this would also be a good time to reinstall them. To temporarily hold the mesh tight to the grill frame, I'm going to grab some cable ties and foam. The foam can be placed on the paint to protect it, and then it's just a matter of looping the tail end of the tie around the grill and through the mesh. For the best hold, I like to place the head of the tie on the back of the mesh. Generally, I like to get these tight, but there's no need to over-tighten them. After I've placed enough ties around the perimeter to have good contact with the mesh all the way around the frame, I'll trim the tail end of the ties off. With the remaining plyo grip, I'll use this to bond the mesh to the grill. Other adhesives can be used for this step. Another one that I like to frequently use is automotive goop. It's best to get the adhesive in all the areas where the mesh is contacting the grill frame. This will make for a super strong bond, and the mesh will be in there permanently. Smoothing out some of the excess adhesive with a toothpick can be helpful with getting nice, consistent fill. It looks to be fully covered now, so now I just need to wait a few minutes for it to harden up. Once it's cured, I can cut off the ties. Then I'll just remove and discard them along with the foam. Let's flip this around and see how it turned out. Wow, this is really a huge difference from what we started with. The new flat black grill design is a really sleek and modern look and should be a good fit on any 2000 through 2002 Toyota Tundra. If there's any difficulties reinstalling the grill back on the truck, there's one of two things that likely need to be done. This area right here is probably the cause of the problem. This can be fixed by trimming the hood right here and here, or by making a small snip in the mesh in the upper corners as well as that top center area where the guide pin is. Here's a picture of how it turned out for our customer. I hope you liked this video. If you have any questions about this product, then feel free to contact me, and thanks for watching.